Salutations, Exile. In patch 3.10, Delirium League, Spellslinger support was added. It allows you to cast many spells by reserving mana and attacking with a wand. It's simple and effective. You can make many good builds with minimal theory crafting. So I thought, I'll do you one better. Instead of using Spellslinger, which reserves mana and has a half second cooldown, I'm going to have no reserved mana and a quarter second cooldown. And instead of triggering from wand attacks, it's going to trigger from spell casts. We cast a spell using Archmage support to drive the mana cost up, use Scold's Bridle to take 400% of that as damage, and use Caster Damage Taken to sling spells. We're triggering spells by casting spells. Now this is spell slinging. The spell I've chosen to cast is Blade Blast, while the triggered spells are the other blade spells. We inch ever closer to the legendary Blade Blade. This is a fairly efficient way to scale our damage. However, efficiency goes completely out the window when we have to mitigate all of this self-damage. We use the Hierophant Ascendancy and the Cloak of Defiance unique chest to take 50% of damage as mana. And we use the Agnostic Legion Keystone to recover life. With both of those mechanics and the Archmage mana cost, however shall we sustain our mana? Rallying Cry has a unique threshold jewel, Spirited Response. We can stack two of them for 20% of damage taken gained as mana over 4 seconds. This value scales with Warcry buff effect. We use Warcry buff effect medium cluster jewels to allocate Cry Wolf, which allows us to Warcry with no nearby enemies, and anoint Battle Cry, which makes Warcries instant, so we can have 100% uptime with minimal hassle. We also obtain the correct amount of Warcry buff effect using these two jewels with two prefixes and no suffixes. You may assume I crafted these by using alteration orbs until I had one prefix and using a regal orb for the other prefix. I didn't have any alteration orbs. I spammed chaos orbs and annulled the jewel socket off with the exactly two orbs of annulment I had. Anyway, as long as you have over 50% of damage taken gained as mana, you should sustain. But I wanted to get over 100% to prove that I could, using Battle Rouse, a Clarity Watcher's Eye, and the Crafting Bench mod on Jewelry. This means that eventually, over 100% of all damage taken is recovered, which means that I have theoretically infinite HP. There is a bottleneck, though. We rely on the Agnostic entirely for our life recovery, which means that we can't recover more than 1/5 of our mana times life recovery rate per second. This means that despite using Archmage support for damage, we need to limit our mana cost. Archmage builds generally stack massive amounts of mana, then have an 8,000 mana cost spell. If we did that, we would take 32,000 physical damage and die instantly. So, we need the cost low enough and our physical damage reduction high enough that we only take about 600 to 1,000 damage per cast. This is where things get stupid. Many Archmage builds use the Hierophant Ascendancy and ignore the Sanctuary of Thought node, as it gives 50% less mana cost having the damage. We take that node. There are some nodes on the tree with increased mana and reduced mana cost. We take those. We get endurance charges through the Conviction of Power Ascendancy node, and power charge on critical support. And now, my proudest accomplishment of this build, and the biggest indicator of how bad it is how efficiently it uses Worm Sign. Every stat on this item is being used to its full effectiveness. The Concentrated Effect support is used to make our Bladefall cast more compact, keeping the blades closer to the boss. The armor gives physical damage reduction, and the evasion rating gives evade chance that we need. We really need that flat life. We get reduced mana cost per endurance charge, which we need. And we get rampage, which is always fun. So, with all this reduced mana cost, Scold's Bridle, and some convoluted recovery, we can sling spells without having to use wands. What weapons do we use? Wands. Two obliteration unique wands are excellent for clear speed, and good budget options until we craft better wands. I crafted these by buying the bases, grabbing about 5 essences from my stash, and slapping them on the wands willy-nilly. Basically, you want damage, mana, and cast speed. These are fine. If you still want to use obliteration for clear speed, there's a trick. If our socket colors and links are exactly the same on both sets of wands, we can have auras and vol skills in the same sockets in both sets, and we can weapon swap without deactivating them, even Vol Righteous Fire. So we use obliteration for clear and swap to better wands for single target. How is our damage? For a 2 exalt budget, passable, but not enough for stuff like Uber Elder or the Simulacrum. Good enough for this montage, though. We'll be right back.
of the voices. Each step into delirium. Looking in, getting under my skin. Well, madness never ends. I can't get rid of you. Take my soup. Each last unwrapped in lies. All done for all of time. Rats. Wrong. What was time?